a marvelous legacy created by the genius of a race long gone, the pyramids of San Juan Teotihuacan rise before us as vestiges of the great sacred pre-Columbian city of past centuries. At kilometer 30, on the highway which links Mexico City with the archaeological zone of Teotihuacan, a project was begun on the 16th of January, 1961, which would become the most modern thermoelectric plant in the Valley of Mexico. A study of the subsoil was initiated in order to determine its weight capacity. It provided the necessary data to design effectively the foundations for the buildings and equipment. Rock walls were put up around the site, and there followed the building of the temporary offices for the construction units. A project of this magnitude, which required the transportation of thousands of tons of building materials and equipment, it was necessary that a railroad spur be built, which would lead to the plant site in order to facilitate the delivery of basic materials. The laying of the foundations was executed according to plans affording maximum security and strength. The original plans for the thermoelectric plant of the Valley of Mexico called for installations covering an area of 28.4 hectares, and an increase is now foreseen for one more unit to generate 150,000 kilowatts and two more to produce 250,000 kilowatts each, which combined will generate a total of 800,000 kilowatts. Within the area, there is a substation with four transmission lines carrying 220,000 volts. A project of mammoth proportions, which soon began to erect the towers that would shape its structure. The enormous construction was taking form, sheltered within the valley. All of the structures built by national companies were designed to resist a sway of up to 10% of movement during seismic disturbances. Phase of the work, technical and construction ingenuity were interwoven into one massive coordinated effort. The main steam dome, which weighs 100 tons, was removed from the flat car. Then began the job of hoisting it to a height of over 90 feet to place it upon its previously prepared base. Thousands of cubic meters of concrete, plus the excavation of 900 cubic meters of rock, were required to construct the pedestal for the steam dome. Many long months, the work of experts, construction teams, and technicians proceeded at an accelerated pace. The project was taking shape. The foundations and the structures, perfectly planned and calculated, were made ready to accommodate the most modern machinery, the complementary equipment which would integrate the plant. Results of the systematized effort were more than satisfactory. While the walls of the buildings were being put up, the basic elements of the plant were being completed. Due to the nature of the subsoil in the area of the turbo generator, it was necessary to inject more than 2,000 tons of cement into its base in order to seal it and prevent any settling. A complicated jungle of conductors and tubes, a sort of gigantic nervous system, was being woven. Through it would circulate the forces which would feed the enormous mechanism. Mexico plant, the most efficient in the entire country, which would require only 8,045 BTU for each kilowatt hour generated, which signifies an efficiency of 42.5%. The planning and the construction of the project, as well as the technical characteristics, were a challenge to Mexican engineers and workmen, a challenge which was met thanks to the efficiency, enthusiasm, and professional talent of all the personnel employed. The process of installation was the one related to the assembly of the turbo generator. Work which required precision and infinite detail, along with strength and skilled know-how. The main steam dome was now in place 90 feet high. It would be connected to produce 150,000 kilowatts, 15,000 volts, three phases, 50 cycles per second, and 3,000 revolutions per minute. As mentioned before, the entire generator group, the exciter and condenser, were cemented on a base requiring 2,000 cubic meters of reinforced concrete and necessitating an excavation of 900 cubic meters. In the machine room, a traveling crane with a capacity of 140 tons was installed, aiding indispensably in the work of moving heavy masses. Through its use, the turbo generator was mounted, a feat requiring utmost efficiency on the part of the workforce. This traveling crane will be used in the future for the installation of new units as well as for maintenance of existing units. The generator is moved by a steam turbine consisting of three sections. The high-pressure section, which receives the steam from the superheater of the boiler at a pressure of 1,800 pounds per square inch and a temperature of 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Steam leaves the boiler at 695 degrees to be reheated in the boiler to 1,000 degrees, then passes into a second section of the turbine, and finally to a low-pressure section from where it is released to condense and to initiate once again the closed cycle of steam and feed water. A whole process of precision which translated from plan, plus the reality of techniques, makes possible the magic of creation. Assembly we are watching generates 1,050,000 pounds of steam per hour at a pressure of 1,900 pounds per square inch and at a temperature of 1,005 degrees Fahrenheit. Designed to burn natural gas and fuel oil, its consumption being 116,800 or 74,000 pounds per hour respectively, with an effectiveness of 84.89% and 89.20% respectively. The maximum height of the boiler structure is slightly over 100 feet. The cross-flow cooling tower is being constructed here as part of the water cooling system. It is equipped with a 125 horsepower fan. The excavations for these installations were carried out simultaneously with those of the plant in a coordinated manner. Auxiliary elements of the unit are the three 2,000 horsepower water pumps which feed the boiler. Two are for normal work, and the other is a spare. Also, there are two force-draft fans of 1,250 horsepower each, two 600 horsepower pumps for the circulation of water, plus minor auxiliary components and starting control panels. Another very important aspect of the plant was the construction of the substation. The force of generated power rises from 15,000 volts to 85,000 volts by means of a transformer of 160,000 kVA. This substation serves as a supplier, since the generated and transformed energy of 85,000 volts is delivered to the Compañía Mexicana de Luz y Fuerza, the Mexican Light and Power Company network. Spectacular phases during the testing period was that of the cleaning of the steam pipes, which took place intermittently during a five-day period. Steam, at a pressure of 600 pounds per square inch, was used for this operation. On the 10th of November, 1962, before 2 years of construction had passed, tests were started for putting the unit into service. The system was connected for the first time at 11:45 p.m. on the 3rd of February, 1963. Only 2 years and 17 days had passed since the project had first been started. With proficiency and precision, a highly technical project was being terminated. Vast plains, hitherto unproductive, now served as a base from which the combination of human effort and modern technology provided the elements to produce, by means of a high-tension tower, power which would be diverted to vital areas, working to increase the electrification of the country. Interesting to note what important general services are available in the plant. Among them is a system for delivery of liquid fuel with railroad sidings and equipment capable of unloading up to 10 tank cars simultaneously. Also, there are storage tanks. Currently, there is one with a capacity of 1,100,000 liters And there is space for the future installation of 3 more tanks of this same type. There is also a gas reducing station where pressure is regulated and consumption of fuel is measured. Among the general services of the plant, it should be mentioned that there is a mechanical and electrical shop properly equipped to carry out all maintenance work. There are administration offices located in a separate building, as well as the operations office, which is in the central control area. The plant also has a laboratory where water and fuels are analyzed, thus affording constant control of the elements used. Other general services include a demineralization and purifying plant for water for the boilers and the deep water wells which supply the boiler, plus an emergency well of great size to supply water to the cooling system tower. There are also storage tanks for untreated water and daily supply fuel tanks. In general, the system is complete and constitutes a service structure of great efficiency within a technical and modern installation of this type. One of the keynotes of success has been the constant task of adjustment, valve checks, inspection, and minute control of the plant itself. A high regard for efficient workmanship, which forged a spirit of responsibility and professional security, was one of the achievements gained during the construction of the project. The plant is a marvel of technical control. The finished project offers new perspectives, neatness in the installation, and the magic of modern technology. Apart from secondary control panels, with starters to put motors generating 480 volts in operation, and control boards with switches to feed motors generating 4,160 volts for the principal secondary services, there is a single master control board for the entire plant. It is awesome to listen to the rhythmic humming of hidden machines and to watch the minute readings on the dials, which are the only evidence that energy is being created. All of the auxiliary motors are controlled from the master control board, where vital data is received indicating the operation of each phase of the system, including a television screen upon which the interior function of the boiler can be seen. Magical modern technology and the most efficient thermoelectric plant in the nation. Cleanliness, silence, creativity, power and energy. The engine room is the radiant antechamber to the very place where energy itself is created for electrification of the nation. From here, as if from a spring flowing with light and power, the force which creates jobs, progress and well-being is generated. Once lay only stone, dormant for centuries, there now rise modern buildings which harbor within their walls the structure of a working organization which provides vital energy for the development and progress of modern life. Out of ancient sterile earth, a creative plant generating light and power has blossomed in the outskirts of a city which was constructed by an autochthonous people who worshiped the sun, to whom they erected pyramids, sensing somehow that it contained a force essential to life. This new plant becomes one more link in the chain of electrification of the country. Project was inaugurated by the President of Mexico, Adolfo López Mateos. After touring the plant and its installations, President López Mateos threw the master switch, which today provides new energy, so vital to the growth and development of the nation. Machinery in motion, energy put to the service of the nation, the nerves which flex the muscles of steel within the general structure of the country. As Mexico grows, evidenced by statistics, each day requires new sources of work, as well as a greater capacity for production and successive progress. It is for this reason that the Valley of Mexico thermoelectric plant carries such a vital mission, because it creates energy to augment the industrialization of the country. The productive electrical potentiality of the Valley of Mexico plant, added to existing sources of electrical power, are helping to fill the needs of the people and the nation's economy. Light and power are indispensable elements in modern life, vital to industry, the country, and the home. At night, the Valley of Mexico is ablaze in multicolored lights. All of these hues of color have their origin in electricity. Once the day's work is done, happiness is rewarded in luminescence. From each light bulb, a potential spark is born, a sparkle of well-being and comfort, a promise that in the immediate future, each new source of energy will turn into a motor to move a large sector of the economy toward even further progress. The power produced within a few kilometers of the pyramids of Teotihuacan at the Valley of Mexico plant contributes to the splendor of the city, whose constant growth holds a promise of future, work, and well-being. To contribute to this dream, to collaborate to the nation's splendor, that is the main goal to which the Valley of Mexico thermoelectric plant aspires. A project created by Mexicans who know they are building their own future and prosperity.